to sight. And what happened? The spaces of the fourth bulb, how it called? The space of fourth bulb. How called the space of the fourth bulb? I mean, the how growing the thalamuses. What's the name of the fourth bulb? I repeat again. Thalamuses. Imagine the brain at first grow like the smallest bulb, right? And the neuron cells start to migrate from different sites, and most of them migrate to side, and make the thickest lateral wall, thalamuses. But what lay between thalamuses? What's the name of the space? No, it's so easy. No. You repeat again, I repeat again. Space into the bulb. Empty space. And at last is the empty space. But where is located this empty space? I told for you, the most migrate to side and make the thalamuses. But within the thalamuses, what is the name of the space?
Body.
This one. There is so easy, very easy. Space. Okay, midbrain, grow like a bulb too. But mostly has a rather thickest from the different side. No, back more thin, right? But what is the spaces of midbrain? Because the midbrain grow like a bulb too. What is the space inside the midbrain? No, into the midbrain. What space into midbrain?
Cerebral aqueduct
is the spaces. The same one. Thalamuses is a bulb. The most cell migrate to site. What is the name of the space between thalamuses?
Ventricle.
Чё ventricle, right? What I mean, the all parts of thalamuses, of diencephalon, excuse me, grow around the third ventricle. Understand? But what I want to tell for you, the most thickest part of diencephalon is the lateral, is the thalamuses, because most cells migrate to sides. Understand me? And the thickest part of diencephalon is the thalamuses. What function of thalamuses itself? Thalamuses has an egg shape, right?
Mm-hmm.
It has anterior pole, posterior pole. No, look, this one, this egg, you can see it. Did you see the egg? The front pole, the back pole. The front pole of thalamuses cannot to be clearly seen because it's strongly attached with the white matter of telencephalon, white matter of hemispheres. But back pole of thalamuses can clearly see. Back pole. The back pole of thalamuses is called pillow or pulvinar. Pillow or pulvinar. Summary, what function of the thalamuses? Why for you needs has a thalamuses? Who knows?
Sensory information.
Ну, many centers receive sensor information. You ought to add at your answer one word only. Philosophy. In your mind philosophy, not more concrete. Receive all sensory information. What it means? The all sensory information collected at thalamus. Why needs to collect the sensory information? Because many another center, if you remember, nucleus gracilis, nucleus cuneatus, right? Analyze the sensory information, but why need to collect it? And Alif, what are you doing, Alif? If close the eyes and give me your hand, understand why I need to have the thalamus. I close your eyes, give me your hand. Not open eyes, okay? What if you hold it, your hand?
Thank you for.
Okay. Why you understand it? Look, from the hand you can receive the many information, right? From the receptors of the skin you can receive information about the sizes, right? Weight, temperature of the object, right? From the deep senses you can have receive information about the weight of the object, right? But is a different track, the different neurons. Must be present the center which integrates the all senses. For which? For understanding the object. Understand what I mean? Without integration of information, you never understand what object you hold. Understand what I mean? And thalamuses give for you possibility of understanding. The person which has a damaging of the thalamuses can easily describe for you the size, the weight, the shape of the surface, but never what understand what he's called at his hand. Understand my mind? The person can easily tell, this is the object has some weight, там, perpendicular shape, different surface, can fully describe, but never tell is the form. Understand my mind? Because for understanding the object, for you need integrate the all senses. Understand my mind? Is a function of thalamus plus the pulvinar of thalamus, the pillow of thalamus, the back one parts of thalamus has additional function, right? Who knows? Pulvinar of thalamus, which function has? Subcortical center of vision, you are right. Because the vision sense has a very information, very more than all another senses, 80% of information we receive from the vision. And for analyzing of it information before sending to the chief, we ought to pre-analyze it, right? And last one, what I told for you, the thalamuses has a medial surfaces, which is a lateral wall of the third ventricle. You are right. Where is that? The medial surfaces. You see this? Did you see? Mid surface of thalamus. Next one. Did you see the very smallest particle? This is the floor of the third ventricle. Now, if you give me atlases, I show for you the atlases because the skin is not fully. Look. This one. Smallest patch. Did you see? Is the mid surface of thalamus, right? The both thalamus is connected by interthalamic adhesion, right? Interthalamic adhesion. The fibers can be sent from the one thalamus to another information. Between, below the thalamus, you see the hypothalamical groove, which bordered thalamus and laying downwards hypothalamus. What's the function of hypothalamus? The hypothalamus is the highest center which control homeostasis. What is, what you mean homeostatic center? What it means?
Equilibrium.
No, concretely, which parameters you can tell? Which parameter must be controlled? Thousands of parameters, but give me a few of them. Temperature, blood pressure, right? Concentration of the chemical substance, I mean the ions, right? pH, so many parameters. It controlled by hypothalamus. The anatomically, the hypothalamus in the plate which makes the flow of the third ventricle. It consists from the posterior perforated substance. If you remember space between the brain peduncle, look, where is the hypothalamus? This is the pons, right? It's a brain peduncle. But this one region, did you see? This region is the hypothalamus. At this skin is this one. Posterior perforated substance between the brain peduncle. Next one. Mammillary body. No, I'm not so clearly seen, but no, I can close it right. Posterior perforated substance, mammillary body, tuber senareum, this one part, tuber senareum. Next one, infundibulum with the hypophysis. Infundibulum with the hypophysis. And optic chiasm. I'm sure this is the same one. The hypothalamus is consist from the posterior perforated substance, mammillary body, tuber senareum, great tubercle, infundibulum with hypophysis, and optic chiasm. And optic chiasm. I tried to show for you at visceral surfaces because the hypothalamus is clearly seen at these views. The same one, did you see the brain peduncle? And I start to describe the posterior perforated substance, mammillary body, tuber senareum, in the hypophysis, above hypophysis infundibulum, and optic chiasm, in the parts of the hypothalamus. Look again. If I understand my mind, the lateral wall of the third ventricle is a mid-surface of thalamus, right? But look at the flow. The flow of the third ventricle consists from the two halves. The front half is a described by mu, by me, few seconds. What is that? No, hypothalamus, right? Hypothalamus. But backly, what is that? Backly. Summary, what name of it parts? Look again. Look at this view. Is the third wind?
The flow of the third wind, right?
divide it on the two half, this half and this. The front half is made by hypothalamus, right? Mm-hmm. But this half, what is that?
Tegmental.
Summary, what is it? Who knows, a few seconds ago told her. A few minutes. Ali, what is it? No. Summary, what is the name of it? Aqueduct is a space. It cannot to be make a flow of something. No, right, right. What is it?
Midbrain.
The back half of the floor is made by midbrain. The front half hypothalamus, right? Understand? The front wall, if you look at the spaces of the third ventricle, it has a this space. What it means? It has a longest floor, longest roof, and smallest front and back wall. Understand what I mean? The front wall is made by a few structures on the front wall. This one. Diameter terminalis, terminal line, terminal plate, excuse me. Terminal plate and anterior cerebral commissure. Two parts. Terminal plate and anterior cerebral commissure. Where is that? Terminal plate and anterior cerebral commissure. If you understand my mind, from the optic chiasm, beginning the front wall, terminal plate, anterior cerebral commissure. Understand my mind? The roof. If you understand my mind, the most thicker wall of the third ventricle is which wall?
Lateral.
What it means? Another wall is most thin. And thinnest wall of the third ventricle is a roof. It consists from lamina epithelialis, epithelial plate, is a macroscopic hardly seen structure. You didn't find it on this skin. Understand what I mean? Because a microscopical structure. Only one layer of the cell. Understand what I mean? Because most cells migrate to another side of the third ventricle. Lamina epithelialis. Be attentive, it's not a callosum body, it's not a fornix, it's a lamina epithelialis. Understand what I mean? Next one. The back, the thin parts, thin walls of the third ventricle, the back wall, is a epithalamus. Ну, I guess you hear the many years the scientists and philosophers try to find third eye. Open your third eye. Right? And anatomically it was defined many years ago. What I mean? If you remember my explanation, I told for you the nervous system mostly fully blind for physical stimuli, right? What I mean? It cannot respond to the temperature, cannot respond to the pressure, cannot respond to the light. But investigate the structure of the brain of the birds, the scientists find unique zone of the brain, which can itself change activity under the sun rays. And which is the zone? This is the epithalamus. Feature of the bird skull is the thinnest wall, and the sun rays can easily pass through the thin wall of the bird skull and coming to the brain, and only one part of the bird's brain can have the answer on the different intensity of the sun, is the epithalamus. Understand my mind? And scientists immediately understand this is the third eye, right? Because it can register the rays activity, the sun rays activity. Your skulls can not transparent for the lights, but is the same one parts like a bird's, right? And what function of the epithalamus of the birds and your cell bodies? What is the function of epithalamus? Is it controlling? No, it has a many function, but one of them is the controlling of the biorhythm, biological rhythm. What mean biorhythm? What is that? Present the many biological rhythm, day rhythm, month rhythm, year rhythm, right? What it mean? By day and morning, more you more active than by night and evening, right? This is a day rhythm. By spring and summer, you more active than by autumn and winter. Is a year rhythm, right? The lady better know the month rhythm of activity. The gentleman has the same rhythm, but it's less visible and less intense. Understand my mind? And if you wanna, you can easily register this rhythm of your emotional activity. It has a variables, right? And most of it rhythm consists for the is very controllable by light. Understand my mind? And which zone is controlled? Is the epithalamus. Understand my mind? Plus else, the epithalamus is one of the first part where you can be finding the hormone of dreams, right? What is the hormone of dreams? What is that?
Hormone dreams?
Right, of
melatonin.
Dream. Melatonin, right. It's produced by epithalamus. It's produced by many parts of the brain. Mm-hmm. No, but most that first it can be found at the epithalamus from beginning. From which part it consists of epithalamus? No, one last story about the one part of the epithalamus I described so late. It can be clearly seen if you look at the back of the thalamus, because it's located back, right? In the back wall of the third ventricle. Where is it? No, look at, is this so small? No, I try to describe it this one. Look. What is the schemes? This is the top view of the thalamical brain. You see the thalamus, right? Pulvinar of thalamus. Third ventricle. Did you see? What did you see at the back? From the mid surface of thalamus begins the fibrous. Stria medullari of third ventricle. Medullar fibrous. It continues to the trigonum habenulare, trigon of leash. Understand, Майя? Юль, положишь мне на столик, хорошо? Я уберу потом. Он мне тоже нужен. Просто вместе с платочком.
Платочек
вернуть? Хорошо, спасибо. Trigon of leash. But leash for which organ? The trigon of leash continued to the leash itself. It attached pineal body. Understand my mind? And summary, the epithalamus is the stria medullari of the third ventricle, trigonum habenulare, habenula, and pineal body. Understand my mind? Stria medullari of the third ventricle, триганом хабинуляре, триганов лиш, хабинуля itself, ну, камишура хабинуляре, and the pineal body, is the epithalamus, is the back wall of the third ventricle. Mm-hmm. Sometimes the scientist want to try to find the location of the soul. And again, the epithalamus has the interest for this scientist. Why? Because on the same person, around the pineal body was found the crystal of the brain sand. If it's interesting for you, you can ask the histologist. Around the pineal body sometimes can be found the crystals of the minerals. It called brain sand. And the some person, they called this place like a location of the soul. Understand what I mean? Again, the epithalamus. Where is that? Look, this one. On this view. What you see? You cannot identify clearly the all parts of the epithalamus. But habenula and pineal body is clearly identified here. Right? This one. This is the epithalamus. Again. Stria medullare, this one. Trigonum habenulare with habenula is only one region. And pineal body. This is a back wall of the third ventricle. That's all, right? We describe the full wall of the third ventricle, but doesn't describe fully thalamical brain. I mean the diencephalon. Excuse me. Why? Because I doesn't describe the metathalamus, right? The metathalamus is the interesting part is because it is strongly associated with the midbrain. The metathalamus is located under thalamus. It doesn't make the wall of the third ventricle lay lower. Look at that. What did you see here? You see the midbrain, thalamus, right? Pillow of thalamus, pulvinar of thalamus. And what did you see? What is that? Did you remember?
Calliculus.
Superior and inferior calliculus, right? The calliculus continue to the brachii. Brachii of superior calliculus, brachii of inferior calliculus. It's the axon of the neurons. But brachii continue to the geniculate body. The superior calliculus continue to the brachii of superior calliculus, which finished by lateral geniculate body. Inferior calliculus has a brachii of inferior calliculus, which can finish it by medial geniculate body. Brachii of calliculus and geniculate body is a metathalamus. Did you remember the function, Alif, of superior and inferior calliculus? What is the function? Subcortical center of vision and hearing. What it mean? Superior calliculus, subcortical center of the vision. Brachii of superior calliculus is the axon of the neurons. And lateral geniculate body is the subcortical center of the vision again. Inferior calliculus is the subcortical center of the hearing. Brachii of inferior calliculus is the axon. And medial geniculate body is the subcortical center of the hearing again. Right? And Timilihin now tell for us all subcortical center of the hearing and vision.